Hi everyone, my name is Vineet Kosaraju, and today I will be demoing a 3D component of the Eterna game. Over the summer, I have been working with Dr. Joe Yesselman at the DOS Lab. He is currently working on testing his algorithms for designing and solving 3D RNA puzzles. And so I created this interface to allow Eterna players to also solve these 3D puzzles. I will be demoing the controls and the interface. The goal of the game is to use the motifs on the sidebar on the left to form a stable structure. The structure is stable when it folds up in a complete cycle. This game is a lot like a jigsaw puzzle. You need to take the right motifs and align them on the main screen so that the start of the structure meets the end. To get started, first load the page. You will see an error message pop up that tells you that you're either missing the proper technology or that you have it. If you have it, you can immediately dismiss the message. But if you are missing it, make sure you click on the proper link and navigate to the page to see how you can fix the problem. Once you load the page, you will see that a structure has been given to you to start with. For this demo, the structure that we will be playing around with is the FMN aptamer puzzle. You can navigate around the 3D view by dragging your mouse to pan and scrolling the mouse to zoom. You can also drag in motifs and watch them connect by using the plus sign on the left-hand sidebar. Adding a helix is the exact same as adding a motif. To undo adding a motif, click the undo button. You can also use the controls on the right-hand sidebar to adjust how the structures are displayed. There are several available controls, such as zooming, toggling the display from atoms only to bonds only to all atoms and bonds, changing the type of color displayed from choosing color based on molecule type to choosing color based on Eterna basis, undoing adding a motif, which if there are no more motifs to undo, I'll give an error message, and panning with the arrow keys. Once you are finally done with this structure, you can click the submit button. It will prompt you for the username of your account on the main server. You may submit as many times as you wish, however, only the first three will be accepted, so be careful before submitting. You can also select certain molecules to get information about them in the selection details page. To select a certain molecule, just click it once. It will become green and you will see the details about that molecule in the selection details box. You can also select entire bases. For example, if I wanted to select this entire guanine on which this molecule is, I can double-click, and I will find out that it's a guanine on residue 827. Also, make sure that you do not close the browser tab while playing. There is no autosave or any other feature that will let you import your old sequences. On this interface, chat is currently disabled, so you will not be able to use the chat box. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy playing with this tool.